Okay, so it's now my pleasure to introduce Marco Fratelli from University of Milano, who will be speaking on entropy martingale optimal transport and nonlinear pricing hedging technology. Marco.
So thank you, Rain, and thank you all the organizers, and George especially, and I'm very grateful for their invitation to this conference, and we all hope to see each other in presence not too far from now. And so let me come to the topic of this talk, which is a joint work with Alessandro Dordi, which is also in Milano. And here is the summary of what I will present. So I will start with an introduction, and then we'll give some main result, always in a discrete time setting. The introduction, I will present eight duality formula. And seven of them are very well known. And we will be interested in the last one. And out of this eight duality formula, four of them are with a probability P fixed. And four of them will be in the robust. We can classify this eight duality in other ways. For example, four of them will have no underlying market, and four of them will have a market, so trading is allowed in the market. And one other possible classification is that four is in the case of sublinear, and four will be in the convex case, which I will explain. So in the last duality formula that we are interested, it will be in the case of the robust, we will have the possibility to trade in the market, and it will be in the convex setting. So this is very briefly what we will talk in the introduction. So I will start with a classical notion of a coherent risk measure. This is going to be in the sublinear case because, as you see, this dual representation is a sublinear functional. And here is the risk measure, which depends on a convex cone. And as usual, the convex, the coherent risk measure is the smallest amount such that C is our contingent claim in all this formula. So it's the smallest amount that we have to add in order to make the position acceptable. So you see we have no market because this infimum of the price of the contingent claim is made with respect to all Q, which belongs to P, pi of P, which are the set of all probability measures. So here we have fixed a reference probability. So this is the sublinear case. We can go to the convex case. We are simply adding a penalization here. So this is the representation, the general representation in the convex case. We have exactly everything is the same. We have a convex risk measure, except now that we don't have anymore the cone property. So we have a convex risk measure. Again, no market, and the probability P is fixed. So we are taking the infimum with respect to all probability of absolutely continuous with respect to P. If we now introduce the market, we go to another concept, which is the sub-replication price. Still, the probability is fixed, but this time we are allowing trading in the market. And therefore, the infimum of the price of the contingent claim is taken now over set of martingale probability measure. So we are introducing the notion of trading in the market. In fact, the sub-replication price is the supremo of the amount M such that there exists delta is a trading strategy such that M plus the integral of this trading strategy, we will work in discrete time, so integral will be very simple, just a sum, so that this quantity is dominated by the contingent claim that we want to sub-replicate, okay? And this is the sub-replication price. So we are again in the sublinear case because we have no penalization here, and we have this representation. And now we have we are out trading in the market. If we want to go to a other duality formula, very well known, is the Bayer indifference price. This covers the convex case. You see, this is exactly the same as before, except that now we have added a penalization term. So we still trade in the market. We have the infimum with respect to Martinger probability measures. And let me put this in this way. And but this time, the Bayer indifference price is defined in such a way that we start with a utility function, and we build U capital U, which appears here and here, as the indirect utility function, which we all know is the supremum of the expected utility from x plus the integral. So you are allowed to trade in the market, okay? So with this indirect utility, then you define the Bayer indifference price as the supremum M such that you can buy your contingent claim C paying M. And when you compute the indirect utility, you are better off with this strategy paying C and buying C and paying M than doing nothing. So it's better than the capital U at zero. As we see, so there is a relation, of course, between the utility that we are using and the penalization that appears here. If we use the exponential utility, the penalization here will be the relative entropy, for example. But different utility function will get different penalization. So this is where we have classically a fixed probability. In fact, all this formula depends on Martinger measure, which are absolutely continuous with respect to P. All this function, and I will come to the other four duality formula that are more interesting in some sense. The other, but a key property of the functional which we introduced so far is cache additivity, okay? And one other property which is shared by the sub-replication and the indifference price is this kind of integral additivity or integral neutrality, in the sense that if I compute the price of the contingent claims par as an integral, this is simply the price of the contingent claim for all stochastic integral. This is simply because we are using Martinger measure in this in the dual representation, for example. So now we go to a pathwise setting with no reference to probability measures, and we start with very old concept, and many speakers talked about Martinger or optimal transport. So the classical optimal transport is in the sublinear case. Here we have no market, so no Martinger measure, which just have the set of our probability measure having fixed marginal. This is the notation. I will be more precise later on. And we take the infimum with respect to our Q of the price of the contingent claim. And the dual formula says that this is equal to the supremum of the option, of the cost of the option. This is the expectation of the option, of the options psi and phi, which are such that the sum is dominated by the contingent claim that we want to price. Okay, so we have no penalization here, and we have no trading in the market. So the next step was done in a very beautiful paper by Riero, Mierke, and Savaré. And they call this question, this topic, entropy optimal transport, which is exactly the case as I was mentioning before, but they introduce a penalization, and I will be more precise in a moment about what is this penalization. So it's a classical relaxation, as you see, with respect to the optimal classical optimal transport, we are not fixing anymore the set of marginal because we are introducing a penalization. So the infimum now is taking with respect to all measure, not even probability. Okay, so they can are not normalized, they're just positive measures. And the supremum is linked, the object function here, so the same condition as before, but now is not anymore the expectation, but is a functional u, and the penalization and the functional u are, of course, linked. And we will explain how this is the case, even though it is clear, it's convex duality here. So one is the associated by Legendre, by Fenker transform. So the other way that we can generalize the classical optimal transport, instead of adding a penalty, is keeping the same sublinear case, but changing this budget in the sense that we are, can allow trading in the market. And this is exactly what happens in the Martinger optimal transport. Okay, so now we are trading in the market. Here we have Martinger measure, Martinger probability measure, which are which have fixed marginal. We take the infimum of the price of the contingent claim, and here you have a linear price, linear pricing, because we take all options, phi and psi, belonging to a given subset. I will be precise later on, but I, most of you know what this is, so we can sum hedge the contingent claim C, and here you have the price of one option plus the price of the other option. So now you understand these are the seven duality formula, and what we are interested is putting together the generalization of entropy optimal transport and the Martinger optimal transport. So we keep this formulation, but we add here a penalization. So if we do this, we end up to this problem, entropy Martinger optimal transport, which would be the convex case of the Martinger optimal transport. Now, again, here we are allowing trading in the market, and this happens because we have to define the set of sub-hedging options that we can use. Is non-linear because this is not anymore the expectation as in the previous formulas. In the Martinger optimal transfer, we have just the price of the two options, but this will be the value of the two options that we have to specify. And we are relaxing the condition of the Q having fixed margin by introducing a penalization, which could be of the divergence formula. So the question is, this seems to be a very natural way to generalize the optimal transfer, introducing Martinger concept and entropy. And the question is, what is the function SU? And it will turn out, and this is the message that we will provide in this talk, is that it's going to be the optimized certainty equivalent of the utility functional U. Okay, so this SU is coming back to be essentially a convex risk measure, except for the sign minus, okay? Because an optimized certainty equivalent is essentially a convex risk measure. So this is one of the message and actually of this talk. So this is exactly what I introduce in a moment. And we will follow this paper in and we will add the constraint that the infimum of the cost functional is taking over Martinger probability measures, okay? And the other key point is that the associated optimization problem, which was SU before, in the objective function, is given via Fenker coniugacy, depending on the penalization, you have a different SU, or depending on the utility function, you have a different penalization. It's not anymore linear, okay? And we will interpret as a nonlinear sub-hedging value. So let's now be a little bit more precise to explain this duality, even though most of you already know the robust pricing hedging duality. And the idea, the main idea in a robust finance is to observe that the marginal on the underlying price process X, which would be the canonical price process, are known, okay? And this can be assumed, and here are some of the references. If you know a sufficiently large number of plain vanilla options, then this gives you the distribution at each intermediate time. However, you might not have sufficient information to detect precisely Q0 hat, Q0 1, the marginal, and so you relax this condition. And so in order to do this, let's see what we can set some notation here. So with M is the set of Martinger probability on the product space such that the canonical process XT has given a distribution under Q, and so has fixed marginal. So these are the standard notation for the class of admissible integrands. CB is the set is the class of continuous function defined on the product, and omega is the product space of this case. We will generalize this later on, but this is to introduce the first duality we have in mind. And then we have the set of integral. This is in discrete time, so everything is quite simple to define. And so this is the sub-hedging duality obtained by Bagerbot and authors in the model independent framework. And this is exactly what I was saying at the beginning. So this is the problem that we want to generalize. And here you have the expectation under the marginals of each option that you need that you use to hedge. In fact, this supremum of the price of the option such that there exists a trading strategy such that the sum of the option plus the gain are dominated by the contingent claim. Okay, and this is a robust sub-hedging price because it does not depend on P here. It must hold for all omega. Now, so in order to generalize, we take the point of view of entropy optimal transport. So now I'm a little bit more precise on what in the paper of Riero and Mierke and Savare provided. So their optimal entropy optimal transport has this form. So first notice this is our measures, only positive measure, not even probability. And here you have the cost of the contingent claim, and you add this additive structure. In our duality, we will have a more general setting, not necessary of the additive structure. And this is a kind of divergence. And in a moment, I will explain what this is. And also a similar approach has been developed by Pennanen and Perkiw. But we took the point of view of the paper of Riero. So the key idea going from optimal transport to entropy is to relax the marginal constraint. In fact, here you don't have any more fixing the marginal. The fact that you are fixing the taking into consideration the marginal is that this divergence tells you how far the probability mu t is with respect to the Q hat that is fixed, but you don't believe too much. You have not sufficient information to fix exactly the marginal, so you might consider a relaxation of this. And we do the same, except that now we start not with optimal transport, but with Martinger optimal transport. So this is what the problem that we are interested. So this is again another formulation where we are starting to be more precise. Here we are defining what is the penalization. The penalization is defined here, is given through a function V star, which is associated to a given utility function of the investor, okay, through the Fenker transform of V, okay? So this is V star, and you use this to construct this divergence, and of course, if U, T is linear, then the V star will be simply the delta, the Dirac of one, and so that the divergence will be simply the Dirac of this given probability QT. So if you here, you put the delta of QT, you get exactly the fact that you're taking the infimum with respect to probability Martinger measure that have fixed margina. So you obtain as a particular case, the Martinger optimal transport, okay? In the duality I will present, we will not necessarily take this, but this will be a relevant example. So the question now is, what is the dual problem or the primary problem in finance, depending on your point of view? So the primary problem, having this as the dual problem, okay, is the following. So this is always the same budget constraint, and we are taking the supremum, however, over the sum of a utility functional, and assuming that such that there exists a trading strategy and option, and so that the sum of the options plus the stochastic integral is dominated, okay? And let me see what is this functional. Okay, we can read it here. This again is one particular example, but is a relevant example because you see, you start with a utility functional, okay, which shows you this is simply the expectation of the utility of the payoff of the option under a given probability or QT, okay? But you don't use this functional. You take a cash additive version of this, and which is written here, okay? This is because the infimum will be in the dual problem will be over probability measure, so you need to see this kind of stock additive and cash additive. So you take the supremum over constant such that, so you add these two terms, and outside of the expectation you subtract. So here is like adding a stock at time t, because this is the identity function in the canonical space. So this is the stock at time t, and you subtract the value of the stock at time zero, you add the lambda bond, and you subtract lambda bond, and you take the supremum, then this quantity has the property of being cash additive. So this would represent also the optimized certainty equivalent in this particular case. So the primary problem is this nonlinear, because here you don't have anymore the sum of the expectation, but this more general function. And as a consequence, this is the duality that we show, okay? This is the entropy Martinger optimal transport problem, and this now we have exactly the formulation in this example. So let's try to be more precise and to give some result in the general setting. So we start with a Polish space. We take E as the set of possible where the static instrument, so E will contain all static instruments, which are options, let's say, but these are continuous bounded functions. And we start with a functional U that is very generic, okay? It's a functional U on the space of contingent claim, which is a subset here, and just proper and concave. Then you build the penalization through the Fenker transform, and given this definition of D, you have property of D, so it can work very well, even if U has not the continuity assumption that are required sometimes. Okay, so we start with a generic functional U, but of course then we will put some assumption. This is the first theorem. So with if C is lower semi-continuous with compact sub-level set, and the functional U has this property which tells you the behavior of U at minus infinity, but clearly K are vectors in the space because this is a multivariate utility. So we have this assumption to be satisfied. We will call property star, which is a technical assumption of behavior of the utility minus infinity. So we have the duality. In this theorem, there is no trading, there is no stochastic integral, there is no Martinger measure, but this is the duality from which we will deduce the other result. And the set here is again the same, the usual set that you are referring with. The sum of the options are dominated by the contingent claim. Okay, but keep also in mind that we here we have only positive measures. And the infimum is not taking over probability, but only over measure. This is the reason because U is not necessary K-shaded. And in order to get the more specific result, we have to consider more notation. So now, instead of being a Polish space, it's just the product of compact sets in R. And we have X is the canonical projection, and now ET is just subset of this space. Now we have time evolving, so we can consider this. And notice that we are not requiring ET, this, where the set of all possible options, to be contained only in CBKT, okay, but in this more general space. So we allow for more general option for the use of static trading, not just having one single maturity, but and this can be a subset, and I will write down the other assumptions. Here are the assumptions in the dynamic setting. So the contingent claim C must be lower semi-continuity, the same property and this condition. And the other property on the penalization is that must be lower bounded. And finally, that there must exist a measure mu in the domain of the penalization such that this quantity is well defined. Okay, so it's integrable. The contingent claim is integrable. And then is the classical set of static hedging. So are the options now in the domain of the utility functional for which there exists a trading strategy which satisfies the classical condition. Okay, and then with this assumption, we can prove the general duality, nonlinear duality among the entropy Martinger optimal transport problem. And now this is exactly defined through the functional U. Okay, U was a generic functional. We started from U, we build the optimized set at equivalent. This is the classical definition of, or generalized because it's in the setting, but the idea is the same. And notice that the optimized set at equivalent is nothing else than a convex risk measure. So we have this gives you the cache additivity property that is needed in order to have the infimum with respect to probability measure. Now you can take a specific formula of the functional U. So we started from U and we developed D of U, but we can do also, we can start from a penalization and build a utility function D. This will be one example that we will consider in a moment. So this is one possible example. So you start with a bunch of utility functions. They have to satisfy this simple property, L0, L0. You construct V star, as I was mentioning before, from U. And then you build the divergence. Okay, the divergence are given through this function of V star. And this can be denoted as the divergence functions. And then here is the duality induced by utility function. The function that now we are considering is again the one I was mentioning before. And the corollary of that result is that this entropy Martinger optimal transport problem has the dual formulation in terms of the utility function, which is written here. Okay, so this is the supremum of the sum, not of the expectation.
Yes. Marco, can I interrupt briefly? Yes. So I think we're approaching the boundary of our time frame. So okay. I can let you.
Yes, so I'm closing here then. And just notice that you get a particular Martinger optimal transport under the case of linear utility. So I have to stop, right? And we have some example of...
we'll go ahead and wrap up in 2 minutes, if you like.
Ah, okay. If I have 2 minutes, I just want to say that we can do the opposite. We can start with a penalization. The penalization could be given by a given... We have some options for each time, and we have the price of them. Then we construct, it is given a function C, which is convex and a lower semi-continua, and then the function C is used in the next slide. Here, maybe if I write down directly the duality. So you see the penalization is given through a convex function of the this would be the true value, and this would be the theoretical value of the function, right? Then you take we take a function of these differences, you build the penalization. Through this penalization, you build the functional u, and the duality you obtain is this one. Okay, here is the penalization, and here is the function that you are optimizing. So I think that for reason of time, we stop here. And so thank you for your attention.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much, Marco. And a round of applause again from everybody virtually. And I think at this stage, I'm checking the chat room. I think at this stage we can move the remaining questions to the coffee break, because I think many people will want to speak to you there. So
okay, sure.
We can stop at this point. Thank you very much, Marco.
Okay.
Thank you, Marco. Beautiful talk.
Thank you.